Today we are going to discuss apomixis. This term has been derived from apo means without or away, and mixis means syngamy. Here the embryos are formed without involving meiosis and syngamy. That's why this term is known as apomixis. This term apomixis was coined by Winkler in 1908 and has been reported in more than 300 species belonging to 35 families. It is more common in polyploids than diploids. The most common families where apomixis has been reported are Estrescie, Poaceae, Rosaceae and Rutaceae. Apomixis is deformation of embryo without the act of meiosis and syngamy, and such asexual seeds are known as apomictic seeds. These apomictic seeds are able to produce progeny similar to female parent, as they are genetically similar to female parent. In the male sterile biotypes of Terrazacum and Heracium, seeds are formed even if the pollen plants are not present in the nearby area to effect pollination. This indicates apomictic nature of seeds formed. This was experimentally confirmed by removing anthers, stigma and corolla lobes, and still seed set and seed germination ability was normal, and the plants derived from such seeds were identical to the respective mother cells. Many authors favor a broader concept of apomixis, according to which apomixis refers to substitution of the usual sexual reproduction by a form of asexual reproduction which does not involve meiosis and syngamy. There are two main categories of apomixis. Number one, vegetative reproduction. In vegetative reproduction, plants propagate by a part of their body which are named as propagules other than seeds. That is, here the part of the body is functioning as propagule. Second one, that is agamospermy. In this category, plants propagate through seeds, but normal meiosis and syngamy is lacking in the formation of embryo. Based on the origin of the embryo, agamospermy is of two types. Number one, gametophytic agamospermy. Here, embryo develops from a cell of an unreduced female gametophyte, that is embryo sac. Sporophytic agamospermy. Here, embryo develops from the diploid sporophytic cell of the ovule, such as nucellus and integuments. This is also termed as sporophytic or adventive embryony. In gametophytic apomixis, an unreduced embryo sac develops from the megaspore mother cell by failure of meiosis, and this is known as diploispory, or directly from a cell in the nucellus, then it is known as apoispory. The embryo is formed by the unfertilized egg, which is known as parthenogenesis, that is, formation of embryo without fertilization is known as parthenogenesis, or some other cell of the embryo sac, then it is known as apogamete. In gametophytic apomixis, alternation of gametophytic and sporophytic generation is maintained. Now, vegetative reproduction. The plants where vegetative reproduction has replaced the sexual method are known as apomictic plants. That is, in apomictic plants, the sexual reproduction does not take place and propagation of the plants takes place by the vegetative means. The vegetative reproduction takes place by means of bulbils, bulbs, runners, suckers, etc. These propagules are formed by the sporophyte only. Gustafsson has distinguished three types of vegetative reproduction in higher plants. Number one, the propagules are formed outside the floral regions, and despite occurrence of functional sex organs, no fertilization or seed setting takes place. That is, here in the category one, the sex organs are functional, but the fertilization does not take place, and vegetative propagules are formed outside the floral regions, for example Ageo americana and Elodia canadensis. The second category, the propagules are formed outside the floral regions and the plants are sexually sterile. In the category one, there are functional sex organs, but fertilization does not take place. While in the category 2, the propagules are formed outside the floral regions and plants are sexually sterile. For example, Fritillaria imperialis and Lilium bulbiferum. In this group, plants propagate by means of bulbils and bulblets. The propagules are formed, the third category, that is the propagules are formed on the floral branches, either in addition to or in place of the flowers. This phenomenon is commonly described as viviparity. The term viviparity is also used for the sexually formed seeds germinating on the mother plant, as in case of mangroves. Thus, in vegetative reproduction, term vegetative viviparity is applied. This is showing the normal sexual pathway taking place in the plants and apomictic pathways. In the normal sexual pathway, the diploid somatic tissue form the meiosite, that is megaspore mother cell, where meiosis forms the haploid megaspores. The functional megaspore forms the haploid embryo sac, in which there is haploid egg cell. The male gamete fuses with the haploid egg, that is female gamete. Fertilization forms the diploid zygote, and this diploid zygote develops to form the diploid embryo. In the apomictic pathway, the megaspore mother cell does not divide further by meiotic division, and there is formation of and functioning as diploid spore. This diploid spore forms the diploid embryo sac, in which there and the egg formed is diploid. This diploid egg, by the process of parthenogenesis, forms the diploid embryo. In one more case, which is known as apoispory, the meiocytes, that is megaspore mother cells, they may divide by the meiotic division, and sometimes there is formation of spore tetrads, but they are not functional. At the same time, the somatic cell, that is cells of the nucellus or integument, is forming the diploid embryo sac, from in which there is formation of diploid egg, and this diploid egg, by the parthenogenesis, forms the diploid embryo. In the third category, which is known as adventive embryony, the somatic cells directly form the embryo. And as the somatic cells are having diploid set of chromosomes, the embryo formed from the somatic cells, that is by the process of adventive embryony, are diploid. Now, a gametospermy. Number one, adventive embryony. Here, gametophytic generation is completely eliminated. Thus, it seems similar to vegetative reproduction, but it differs from vegetative propagation in the following manner. Number one, it has retained the seed habit and one or more diploid sporophytic cells undergo the stages of embryogeny and grow into mature embryos inside the normally developed sexual embryo sac. The zygotic embryo either degenerates or competes with the apomictic embryos. The adventive embryony leads to formation of more than one embryo in a seed, for example, citrus. This is a very common example where polyembryony has been seen, that is citrus. Now, gametophytic apomixis. In this category, there are two subcategories, that is diploispory and apoispory. Diploispory, in this case, megaspore mother cell differentiates as in sexual ovules, but it does not enter into meiosis. That is, the megaspore mother cell itself behaving as megaspore, and this by the process of mitotic divisions, it forms diploid embryo sac, and there are four types of diploisporic embryo sac development, which has been named according to the genera from where they were first observed. Number one, that is pterozoacum type. The megaspore mother cell enters meiotic prophase and pairing of homologous chromosomes occurs to some extent. However, due to asynapsis, univalents are scattered over the spindle at metaphase first. A restitution nucleus is formed after meiosis 1. The megaspore mother cell with the restitution nucleus divides mitotically to form a dyad with somatic chromosome number. Restitution nucleus means a nucleus that is having double number of chromosome. That is a nucleus where chromosome number gets doubled. After restitution nucleus is formed after meiosis first, and thus the dyad cells which are formed are having diploid set of chromosomes. Usually the micropylar cell of the dyad degenerates while chalazal cell undergoes further mitotic divisions to form an 8 nucleate embryo sac. This type of diploispory occurs in Erebus halbellus, Agropyron scabra and Erigeron species. The second type is Ixeris type. In the triploid recess of Ixeris dentata, the megaspore mother cell divides by a semi-heterotypic asyndetic meiotic prophase in which there is no pairing and a restitution nucleus results. The restitution nucleus undergoes three mitotic divisions leading to the formation of an 8 nucleate embryo sac. The third type is Antenaria type. The megaspore mother cell does not enter meiosis and acts as an unreduced megaspore. After a long interphase, it increases in size and appears like functional megaspore. By mitotic divisions, it forms an unreduced 8 nucleate embryo sac of polygonum type. The fourth category is Allium type. In this type of diploispory, pre-meiotic chromosome doubling is the cause of unreduced embryo sac formation. Chromosome number in megaspore mother cell is doubled by endomitosis and the ensuing meiosis results in a dyad of unreduced cells. Two subsequent mitosis in the chalazal dyad cell results in an 8 nucleate embryo sac. Now, apoispory. The normal megaspore mother cell differentiates in the same manner as in sexual ovules and begins to enter meiosis and may or may not complete both divisions to form a linear tetrad. At the same time, some nucellar cells become meristematic and appear like megaspore mother cell. These cells undergo mitotic divisions to form an unreduced embryo sac. In obligate apoespore, the sexual megaspore mother cell or its products abort, and the apoesporous embryo sac occupies the entire area of the ovule. The timing of degeneration of sexual embryo sac depends on the time of initiation of apoesporous embryo sacs. Apoespore is the most common method of apomixis in higher plants, and it was first reported by Rosenberg in Heracium species. Sometimes apoesporous and sexual embryo sacs may exist together. Apoespore is of two types, Heracium type. In Heracium, the megaspore mother cell undergoes the usual meiotic divisions and forms a tetrad. At this stage, a nucellar cell at the chalazal end becomes activated and starts developing into an apoesporous unreduced embryo sac. All the four megaspores degenerate while apoesporic embryo sac matures. This type of apoesporic embryo sacs are eight nucleate. Here in Heracium type, the megaspore mother cell divides by meiotic division and it forms the spore tetrads. But the spores degenerate and apoesporic embryo sac develops from the nucellar cells, or it may sometimes develop from the integument. The second category of apoespore is panicum type. In panicum and some other grasses, the apoesporous embryo sac is four nucleate, organized into three-celled egg apparatus and a polar nucleus. Antipodals are absent. P. Maheshwari, 1950, recognized three types of apomixis. He categorized the apomixis into non-recurrent apomixis, recurrent apomixis, and adventive apomixis. In non-recurrent apomixis was categorized into two parts, haploid parthenogenesis and haploid apogamy. Recurrent apomixis was further categorized into generative apoespore and somatic apoespore, and adventive apomixis. We have already discussed these terms earlier. Now, the embryo and endosperm development. Diploespore as well as apoespore produce diploid embryo sacs. To complete the apomictic cycle without altering the number of the sporophytic generation, the diploid egg must develop into embryo without the participation of the male nucleus. Formation of embryo from an unfertilized egg is called parthenogenesis. Although the embryo development is in apomixis occurs without the union of male and female gametes, but pollination stimulus is required for the full development of the embryo and endosperm. It is very important to note that although there is not fusion of male and female gametes, but pollination stimulus is required for the full development of embryo and endosperm. Now, significance of apomixis. Apomixis does not involve meiosis, thus it is useful in preserving desirable characters for indefinite period.